Hi. In the last session, we discussed about the Galois extension and the Galois group. We defined what a Galois extension is and also we defined what a Galois group is. In this session, we give some examples of Galois extension and Galois group. In the first example, we show that q root 2 over q is a Galois extension, but q cube root of 2 over q is not a Galois extension. To show q root 2 over q is a Galois extension, by definition, it is enough to show that the order of the automorphism group of q root 2 over q is same as the degree of extension of q root 2 over q. So, but in the previous session, we have seen that the automorphism group of q root 2 over q contains two elements, namely 1 and sigma, where sigma takes root 2 to minus root 2. So, therefore, the order of the automorphism group q root 2 over q is same as 2. Now, what is the degree of the extension q root 2 over q? This degree is actually the degree of the minimal polynomial of root 2 over q. But what is the degree minimal polynomial of root 2? The minimal polynomial of root 2 is same as x square minus 2 and its degree is 2. Therefore, the degree of extension q root 2 over q is equal to 2. So therefore, both the order of automorphism of group of q root 2 over q and the degree of extension of q root 2 over q are same. Therefore, q root 2 over q is a Galois extension. Now, about q, the extension q, cube root of 2 over q. We have seen that the automorphism group of q, cube root of 2 over q contains only one element, namely 1. And therefore, the order of the group of automorphism of q, cube root of 2 over q is equal to 1. And the degree of extension q, cube root of 2 over q is equal to the degree of the minimal polynomial of q, cube root of 2, which is same as degree of x cube minus 2, which is equal to 3. Therefore, these two values are not same. Therefore, q cube root of 2 over q is not a Galois extension. Now, in the next one, we need to show that q fourth root of 2 over q is not a Galois extension. But q fourth root of 2 over q root 2 and q root 2 over q are Galois extensions. So, why q fourth root of 2 over q is not a Galois extension? The minimal polynomial of fourth root of 2 over q is h raised to 4 minus 2. And its roots are fourth root of 2 plus or minus fourth root of 2 and plus or minus I fourth root of 2. But plus or minus I fourth root of 2 does not belong to q fourth root of 2. Because it's a complex number and q fourth root of 2 is contained in reals. Therefore, the only roots of h raised to 4 minus 2 belongs to q fourth root of 2 is plus or minus fourth root of 2. Therefore, any sigma in automorphism of q fourth root of 2 over q takes fourth root of 2 to either 1 of fourth root of 2 or fourth minus fourth root of 2. Therefore, there are only two choices of automorphisms of the extension q fourth root of 2 over q. Therefore, this automorphism of group contains two elements. But the degree of extension q fourth root of 2 over q is 4 because it's four, the minimal polynomial of fourth root of 2 is h raised to 4 minus 2 and its degree is 4. So, the order of the automorphism of q fourth root of 2 over q is not equal to the degree of extension q fourth root of 2 over q. Therefore, q fourth root of 2 over q is not a Galois extension. But in the previous question, we have seen that q root 2 over q is a Galois extension. Now we'll see what about q fourth root of 2 over q root 2. The q fourth root of 2 is the splitting field of the separable polynomial h square minus root 2 over q root 2, because h square minus root 2, the roots are plus or minus fourth root of 2, and they are belongs to q fourth root of 2. So q fourth root of 2 is the splitting field of the separable polynomial h square minus root 2 over q root 2. Therefore, q fourth root of 2 over q root 2 is a Galois extension. And in the previous example, q root 2 is over q is a Galois extension, we have seen, because, or we can give another argument saying that a q root 2 is the splitting field of the separable polynomial h square minus 2 over q. Therefore, q root 2 over q is a Galois extension. So this example says that q root 2 over q and q fourth root of 2 over q root 2 are Galois extension, but q fourth root of 2 over q is not a Galois extension. So this is an example of extension fields f contained in e contained in k such that e over f and k over e are Galois extension, but k over f is not a Galois extension. Now we will see another example. We can show that q root 2 root 3 over q is a Galois extension. And also we have to find what the Galois group of this extension is. Now consider this polynomial h square minus 2 into h square minus 3. And this is definitely a separable polynomial because all roots are distant, because the roots are plus minus root 2 and plus minus root 3. And q root 2 root 3 is the smallest field containing q root 2 and root 3. Therefore, q root 2 root 3 is the splitting field of the separable polynomial h square minus 2 into h square minus 3. Therefore, q root 2 root 3 over q is actually a Galois extension, because we have seen in the previous session as a corollary, which says that k is the splitting field over f of a separable polynomial, then k over f is a Galois extension. So we now try to find the Galois group of this extension. That means we try to find the all automorphisms of q root 2 root 3, which fits us elements of q. So any automorphism of q root 2 root 3 is determined by the images of root 2 root 3 under that automorphism. Now what are the possible images of root 2 root 3 under any automorphism? We have seen in the previous session that root 2 will be goes to any one of the roots of the minimal polynomial of root 2. But what is the minimal polynomial of root 2? Is h square minus 2. And its roots are plus minus root 2. Therefore, under any automorphism sigma of q root 2 root 3, always takes root 2 to either root 2 or minus root 2. Similarly, root 3 is also maps to plus or minus root 3. Therefore, there are four possible automorphisms of this group. They are root 2 takes to root 2 and root 3 takes to root 3. The second automorphism takes root 2 to minus root 2 and root 3 to root 3. And third one takes root 3 to root 2, root 2 to root 2 and root 3 to minus root 3. And the fourth one takes root 2 to minus root 2 and root 3 to minus root 3. So the Galois group of q root 2 root 3 over q contains four elements, which is defined over there. And the degree of the extension of q root 2 root 3 over q is also 4, because q root 2 root 3 over q, the degree of extension, which is same as q root 2 root 3 over q root 2 into q root 2 over q. So which is same as 2 into 2, because in the first degree of extension is same as the degree of the minimal polynomial of root 3 over q root 2, which is same as 2. And second one is the degree of the minimal polynomial root 2 over q, which is same as 2. Therefore, the degree of the extension q root 2 root 3 over q is 4, and the Galois group contains 4 elements. Now we have to check that what are these four elements. We know that any group of order 4 is abelian, so, and it is either isomorphic to Z4 or Z2 cross Z2. That means any group of order 4 is either a cyclic group or a clean 4 group. So we have to check this Galois group is either a cyclic group or a clean 4 group. So first we take two elements of this group, which is sigma and tau, which sigma takes root 2 to minus root 2 and root 3 to root 3, and tau takes root 2 to root 2 and root 3 to minus root 3. Okay, so then what about sigma square of root 2? Sigma square of root 2 is same as sigma of root 2, which is same as sigma of minus root 2, because root 2, sigma of root 2 is equal to minus root 2. And which minus root 2, I can write it as minus 1 into root 2. So because sigma is a multiplicative homomorphism, you can write it as sigma of minus 1 into sigma of root 2. And which is same as minus 1 into minus root 2, because minus 1 is in Q and sigma fixes elements of Q. So sigma of minus 1 is equal to minus 1. And sigma of root 2 is equal to minus root 2. So their product is equal to root 2. That means sigma square takes root 2 to root 2. Similarly, sigma square takes root 3 to root 3. That means sigma square takes every element of Q root 2 root 3 to itself. That means sigma square is identity map. Similarly, we can show that tau square is also identity. So we got two elements in this group. One is sigma and the other one is tau. And sigma square is 1, tau square is also 1. What about sigma 2? Sigma tau of root 2 is sigma of tau of root 2, which is equal to sigma of root 2, which is equal to minus root 2. And similarly, sigma tau of root 3 is minus root 3. That means sigma tau of root 2 is minus root 2 and sigma tau of root 3 is minus root 3, which is same as the fourth automorphism which we obtained in the previous slide. So all the elements of and also sigma 2 the whole square is equal to 1, because any group of order 4 is abelian and sigma square and tau square is 1, so you got a sigma 2 the whole square is equal to 1. So the Galois group of Q root 2 root 3 over Q, which contains 1, sigma, tau and sigma 2, these are the four elements of Galois group of Q root 2 root 3 over Q. And we have seen that sigma square is 1, tau square is 1, sigma 2 is also 1, and it's an abelian group, so it is isomorphic to clean 4 group. So the Galois group of Q root 2 root 3 over Q, or the Galois group of the extension Q root 2 root 3 over Q, is the clean 4 group. Let us see another example. Cube root of 2 omega over Q. We want to show that this extension is a Galois extension, where omega is the primitive cube root of unity. Now consider the polynomial h cube minus 2. What are the roots of h cube minus 2? They are cube root of 2, omega into cube root of 2, and omega square into cube root of 2, where omega is the cube root of unity. So therefore, Q cube root of 2 omega is the splitting field of the separable polynomial h cube minus 2. Therefore, Q cube root of 2 omega over Q is a Galois extension, because it is the splitting field of a separable polynomial over Q. So this extension is a Galois extension. Now we will try to find what is the Galois group of this extension. So first of all, we will see what is the number of elements in this group. So the number of elements in this group is same as the degree of extension Q, cube root of 2 omega over Q. And then this degree of extension, we can write it as the degree of Q, cube root of 2 omega over Q, cube root of 2 into Q, cube root of 2, the degree of extension Q, cube root of 2 over Q, which is same as 2 into 3, which is equal to 6. Why it is 2? Because the first degree of extension, that means the degree of extension Q cube root of 2 omega over Q cube root of 2, is same as the degree of the minimal polynomial of omega over Q cube root of 2. But this minimal polynomial is 1 plus h square. And its degree is 2. So therefore, the first degree of extension is 2, and second degree of extension is same as the degree of the minimal polynomial of q root 2 over q, which is same as the degree of the minimal polynomial x cube minus 2, which is 3. So you got the degree of extension of q, cube root of 2 omega over q is same as 6. That means the Galois group of the extension q, cube root of 2 omega over q contains 6 elements. That means this group is a group of order 6. Now if you know that any automorphism sigma of this group determined by the images of cube root of 2 and omega. Now you know that what are the possible images of cube root of 2 and which is same as the root of the minimal polynomial of cube root of 2. Now what is the minimal polynomial of cube root of 2? Which is same as h cube minus 2. And what are the roots? The roots are cube root of 2, omega cube root of 2, omega square cube root of 2, where omega is the cube root of unity. Therefore, the possible images of cube root of 2 under any automorphism sigma in this Galois group is either cube root of 2 or cube root omega into cube root of 2 or omega square into cube root of 2. And what are the possible images of omega? The possible images of omega are the roots of the minimal polynomial of omega. And the minimal polynomial of omega is h square plus h plus 1. So the roots are omega and omega square. So the possible images of omega under any automorphism of the Galois group is omega or omega square. So we have 6 possibilities, and we want to identify what this group is. So we consider the automorphism sigma tau, which is defined by sigma takes cube root of 2 to omega cube root of 2, and sigma takes omega to omega. Tau takes cube root of 2 to cube root of 2, and tau takes omega to omega square. Remember, omega is the root of the polynomial 1 plus h square. Therefore, 1 plus omega square is 0. So, omega square is minus 1 minus omega. So, what are the other elements of the group? The other elements is definitely one is identity, which takes cube root of 2 to cube root of 2 and omega to omega. And the second one is sigma square. Sigma square takes cube root of 2 to omega square cube root of 2 and omega to omega. Under tau sigma, cube root of 2 goes to omega square cube root of 2 and omega goes to omega square. And under tau omega square, cube root of 2 goes to omega cube root of 2 and omega goes to omega square. And these are the only 6 possibilities we can obtain from the choices of images of cube root of 2 and omega for any automorphism of q cube root of 2 omega. So also sigma tau of cube root of 2 is equal to sigma of tau of cube root of 2, which is same as sigma of cube root of 2, which is equal to omega cube root of 2, and sigma tau of omega is equal to sigma of tau of omega, which is same as sigma of omega square, but sigma of omega square is sigma of omega into sigma of omega, so which is same as omega into omega, which is omega square. So sigma tau is equal to tau sigma square. Because in the previous slide, we have seen that tau sigma square takes cube root of 2 to omega cube root of 2 and omega to omega square. That means that sigma tau is same as tau sigma square. Therefore, we got the group contains, we have taken 2 elements, sigma and tau. And we have seen that the other elements of the group are the identity, sigma square, tau sigma, and tau sigma square. And this is precisely, and sigma cube is 1 and tau square is 1. Therefore, G is the group generated by sigma and tau with sigma cube is 1, tau square is 1. That means order of sigma is 3 and order of tau is 2. And sigma tau is equal to tau sigma square. And this is the group which is isomorphic to S3. Therefore, the Galois group of the extension Q cube root of 2 omega over Q is isomorphic to S3. Now let us see the other one. We'll see one example of a finite group. So we have to show that Fp raised to n over Fp is a Galois extension. And its Galois group is a cyclic group of order n. Now we know that Xp raised to n minus x is a separable polynomial, because x raised to p raised to n minus x and its derivative, and its derivative is minus 1 because p is the characteristic of this field, and they have GCD 1, therefore that means they are co-prime. That means the polynomial x raised to p raised to n minus x and its derivative, which is same as minus 1, and they are co-prime, therefore x raised to p raised to n minus x is a separable polynomial. Because it's a finite field, the separable polynomial of x raised to p raised to n minus x, the splitting field of the polynomial x raised to p raised to n minus x contains exactly p raised to n and are the roots of this polynomial. So this roots contain definitely 1 and 0. So Fp raised to n is a field which contains p raised to n elements and which is an extension of p. And because Fp raised to n contains all the roots of h raised to p raised to n minus h, and h raised to p raised to n minus h is a separable polynomial, therefore Fp raised to n is the splitting field of the separable polynomial h raised to p raised to n minus h over Fp. Therefore Fp raised to n over Fp is a Galois extension. Now what is the degree of the extension Fp raised to n over Fp? Which is definitely n, because there are p raised to n elements, and therefore the basis of Fp raised to n over Fp as a vector space, we get there is only n elements. And so any element of Fp raised to n, you can write it as the linear combination of these n elements. And so you are writing each ai's, that means summation ai xi, any element in Fp raised to n is of the form a1x1 plus a2x2 plus etc plus anxn, where x1 is to etc, xn is the basis of Fp raised to n or Fp as a vector space. So, but this ai's are belongs to Fp, and therefore, and Fp contains only p elements. So each coefficients has n p choices. So there will be p raised to n elements for this. So the degree of extension Fp raised to n over Fp is equal to n. Therefore, the Galois group of Fp raised to n over Fp is also n. Which contains n elements. That means the order of the Galois group of Fp raised to n over Fp is equal to n. Now consider the Frobenius map sigma from Fp raised to n to Fp raised to n, which takes alpha to alpha raised to p. We know that that map is a homomorphism, ring homomorphism, and it is injective also, because sigma of alpha is equal to 0 implies alpha raised to p is equal to 0 implies alpha is 0. That means kernel of sigma is equal to 0, so it is an injective map. So sigma is an injective map from a finite set to itself. Therefore, it is a surjective map. Hence, sigma is an automorphism of Fp raised to n. And note that sigma square of alpha is sigma of alpha, and which is same as sigma of alpha raised to p. So, which is same as alpha raised to p, the whole raised to p, which is same as alpha raised to p square. Similarly, for each I is equal to 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc., we get a sigma raised to I of alpha is equal to alpha p raised to I. And alpha p raised to n is equal to alpha, because alpha is an element of Fp raised to n, and alpha, so it is a root of h raised to p raised to n minus h. So alpha raised to p raised to n minus h is minus alpha is 0, so alpha raised to p raised to n is equal to alpha. But alpha raised to p raised to n, by above statement, it says that it is same as alpha sigma raised to n alpha. So you are getting sigma raised to n alpha is equal to alpha for rho, each alpha belongs to fp raised to n. That means that a sigma raised to n is identity. Now we will check, is there any lower power of sigma is identity. If sigma raised to I is equal to identity for I less than n, then sigma raised to I of alpha is equal to alpha for all alpha belongs to fp raised to n. That means that each element of fp raised to n is a root of the polynomial x raised to p raised to I minus x, which is not possible because fp raised to n contains n p raised to n elements, and the polynomial x raised to p raised to I minus x has maximum p raised to I elements and I is less than n. So therefore this sigma raised to I is equal to 1 is not possible for I is less than n. Therefore sigma is an element of order n in the Galois group of order n. So therefore the Galois group is a cyclic group and it is generated by that sigma whose order is n. So therefore the Galois group of fp raised to n over fp is a cyclic group of order n generated by the Frobenius map sigma. That's all for the day. In the next session, we discuss about more examples of Galois group, in particular Galois group of polynomials. We'll see. Thank you.